Hey guys, welcome back to the Fergie Time podcast. Since being promoted to the Premier League, Wolverhampton Wanderers have achieved great success, finishing seventh twice and reaching the quarterfinals of the Europa League. The man at the helm during the success has been none other than Portuguese manager Nuno Espirito Santo. Under Santo, Wolves have utilized great scouting, player recruitment, and player development to turn relatively unknown players like Raul Jimenez, Adama Traore, and Ruben Neves into stars. While Wolves have now shown that they can consistently compete for Europa League qualification, the question many are asking is, can they now take the next step and compete for the top four? To answer this question, let's first take a look at their activity in the summer transfer window. Wolves decided to sell Matt Doherty for roughly £18 million to Spurs. Doherty had thrived at Wolves the past two seasons, tallying 8 goals and 8 assists from the right wing back position. They also decided to sell Diogo Jota for £50 million to Liverpool. While Jota is no doubt a talented young player, he didn't always fit into Nuno's preferred system. Using the £70 million roughly made from selling Doherty and Jota, Wolves have gone out and strengthened their squad. First, they signed Marcal from Lyon, the £1.7 million versatile and veteran left-back that will help contribute to build-up play and will also be very threatening in the attack. Next, they signed Kjaer Nåhøyberg from Liverpool for a fee of roughly £8.5 million. While the 18-year-old right back will not make tons of appearances this season, he adds depth to the position and will also be a player for the future as he is a talented youngster in his own right. Wolves followed up these two smaller signings by bringing in Fabio Silva for £35 million, a club record fee. The 18-year-old wonder kid plays up top and his talent has been likened to that of Cristiano Ronaldo by club legend Manuel Fernandez at Sporting. So this kid has a very, very bright future. May not feature a bunch this year, but nonetheless has a bright future at Wolves. And most recently, Wolves made a splash signing by going out and signing right back Nelson Semedo from Barcelona for £35 million. He is a high-flying right back that is energetic in the attack and makes really fast, hard runs forward. Really fun player to watch, and I think he's a great upgrade over Doherty. While Wolves receive a lot of praise for their recruitment, I find Nuno to be often undervalued by the mainstream media as a tactician. One reason Wolves have sustained success for two seasons in the Premier League is because their style of play is unique and hard to match up against. Wolves tend to line up in either a 3-4-3 or a 3-4-1-2 and adjust well to their opposition. Wolves also like to exploit the wide areas, using their wingbacks to get involved in the attack. The midfield pairing of Neves and Moutinho helped to pivot the ball out wide to wingers like Adama Traore to create mismatches. So, now that we know a little more about Wolves and how they play, who are they going to be competing against for the top four spots? Well, in my opinion, Liverpool, Man City, and Chelsea will all qualify for a Champions League spot. That leaves Manchester United, Arsenal, and Spurs as Wolves' main competition. And to be honest with you, none of these teams share confidence in me. Just this past weekend, Manchester United lost 3-1 to Crystal Palace, and over the summer, they failed to really strengthen their squad. Arsenal are in some good form. However, in my opinion, they are still a signing of either Aouar or Partey away from being a lock for a top four spot. And then Spurs are looking inconsistent as ever, despite recently signing both Gareth Bale and Reguilón. And that leaves the door open for Wolves. And while I'm not going to predict they finish in the top four in this video, barring injury, it would not surprise me if they do. Thank you guys for watching. Let me know down below in the comments if you think Wolves will finish in the top four in the Premier League this season. Also, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to smash the like button and subscribe for more amazing football content. We will end it there. Thank you and take it easy. Peace. I see the blue in her eyes from the sunshine. See the purple in her heart when it's nighttime. She just wanna be. She couldn't give a damn about the limelight, so orchestrate your death.